unfortunately, one of the side effects of everything, that, I guess all the trauma you would call it, is that I still have interrupted sleep and really bad night terrors and bad dreams and things like that. Quite vivid dreams at times. I do overall, I think, sleep a lot better up here though. I find the worst times is probably when I hear car doors slamming at night, or the sound of the some cars, like the big ones that have sound a bit like the police paddy wagons, have that kind of loud it's a particular sound of a running engine, and that gives me like really intense anxiety. My heart will start to race and pound, and I get really clammy skin and shallow breathing, and sort of freeze as well. Sometimes even just hearing voices over like a walkie-talkie thing, intercom. Oh, just the sound of sometimes phones also. Phone notifications or certain ringtones. Just seeing police. There's actually quite a lot of triggers now that I think of it. Yeah, it's something I'm just still working through, but yeah, I have been diagnosed with PTSD and something called like a hypervigilance, I think it was called. Yeah, I've struggled with anxiety and depression for quite a long time before this anyway. Trauma in my childhood as well. Unfortunately, the Jehovah's Witness upbringing, and spiritual abuse, emotional abuse, and then obviously, yeah, the not being diagnosed with the borderline until later in life, and that's, yeah, made things tricky, because I guess I wasn't getting the right help in my 20s and early 30s that I really needed even as a teenager. I always felt a particular way, but tried to get help for it, and was put on various different antidepressants and diagnosed with anxiety and depression, but the anxiety and depression actually was a side effect of the borderline, but the borderline wasn't diagnosed until much later in life. So I've always been this way. It's not like when I got diagnosed with the borderline that I suddenly changed. That was actually a good thing, because at least now I've been able to get the right sort of treatment, and I've done this really intense sort of therapy that's tailored to the for people that suffer with borderline. Borderline's just a, well, for me anyway, obviously can't speak for others, but yeah, it's really intense emotions, I guess is how I would describe it. I just feel everything very intensely. Cry a lot. When I'm highly stressed and overwhelmed, that's when the suicidal thoughts and the self-harm sort of thoughts creep in. But I don't have to act on my thoughts, and I don't have to let my thoughts control me. And I know how to manage things a lot better now from what I've learned. In a way, I guess all this stuff that happened more recently with the police and everything and false imprisonment and all the illegal curfew checks, bail checks and everything has been like just a really intense way of testing my resilience and strength. And yeah, look, I got through it and trying to just leave all of that behind me, but it is hard because, as I say, when you get triggered by something and sort of takes you back to that moment and you have a very physical reaction, but things could always be worse.